Om Shri Sai Ram, offering my most humble and loving salutations at the lotus feet of our beloved Bhagwan, Shri Satya Sai Baba. Dear brothers and sisters, this is yet again my privilege and joy to bring you another episode of his story through the eyes of his boys. And by Bhagwan's grace, we have Brother Sai Surendranath continuing the divine saga. And I feel so blessed that Bhagwan has given us so many wonderful opportunities to experience his love, care, and guidance, which are enough for I don't know how many lives to come, if at all. So let us continue this beautiful journey with Brother Sai, and let us start with our prayer, and I request all of you to please join me in. O Lord, take my love and let it flow in fullness of devotion to Thee. O Lord, take my hands and let them work incessantly for Thee. O Lord, take my soul and let it be merged in one with Thee. O Lord, take my mind and thoughts and let them be in tune with Thee. O Lord, take my everything and let me be an instrument to work for Thee. Welcome all of you on this episode of his story through the eyes of his boys. Just a quick introduction of Brother Sai Surendranath. He joined Bhagwan's school for PUC, that is pre-university course, in 1977, then went on to do his graduation and post-graduation from Vrindavan and Prashantinilayam. And later on became, as Bhagwan instructed and guided, the teacher, PG teacher, at Sri Satya Sai Higher Secondary School, Prashantinilayam, in the Department of Commerce. He's been blessed to receive the Best Teachers Award by the Ministry of Human Resources, Government of India, twice. And he's a very, very popular face in the Sai circle, as everybody must have seen him playing tabla, being part of the music group, and obviously very much close to Bhagwan and doing all sorts of services with him. So it's my pleasure and privilege to welcome Brother Sai Surendranath on our program tonight. So Brother Sai, Sai Ram.
Sai Ram.
Welcome and thank you very much for making time to continue this beautiful journey.
Thank you.
So, Brother Sai, we have had a wonderful two sessions with you in which you took us from your grandmother's time and brought us to the era of school. And we learned so much from you about that era, about how Bhagwan was in during your Vrindavan days and then in Parthi. And today, we want to continue this journey. And if I want to just start off, we are talking about Bhajan Hall and the romance of Bhajan Hall with students and Swami. I just want to request you to think of something and share with us that mood so that we can relive those moments. Unfortunately, for many devotees who have not seen the Bhajan Hall, help them to create that. How he was when he used to come to Bhajan Hall, before and after bhajans, and before interview, after interview. So please, I leave the floor to you.
Yes, everybody loves to spend their time inside the Bhajan Hall because they can be very close to Bhagwan, and you can enjoy Swami's proximity in a different ambience. I always felt that Bhajan Hall is not a Bhajan Hall. out of my experience, Bhajan Hall is like a workshop where it brings transformation within the person, and also you see transformation outside. Both it happens. One, when you are with God, when you are living with Him, and when He's pulling somebody's leg and joking with Him, sometimes He's very serious note and trying to correct someone. No, that is one way where physically Swami wants to bring some change in the attitude or in the behavior or the way you are supposed to be in front of Swami or otherwise. At the same time, other people, those who are witnessing this kind of situation, there is some change, inner transformation also it happens. So that can be some miracles, that can be some advice, that can be some great people life where Swami used to share. You have shown the picture where Swami's throne is there and there is a tiger skin and Swami used to sit there and chat before the bhajans. No, he used to chat with the boys. He used to talk about Radha Bhakti. He used to talk about Mirabhai. There are days Swami used to talk about Subbalakshmi, Amma Subbalakshmi, about her devotion and the achievements that he had and how her devotion to Swami. And when she renders the song, she gets immersed into that song, becomes part of the song, you know, her devotion aspect, all on her personal life. So this is how Swami used to give lots of examples, right from mythological to living personality. And, he's trying to encourage us to be, to emulate and to follow some of those things to enrich our life. This is the time where Swami, used to pull legs of boys. I'll tell you one instant where we were all waiting for Swami. I don't know whether I mentioned this.
You can just come in the middle of the camera.
Yeah. I don't know whether I mentioned this or not. Did I mention about the namaskar, one boy taking namaskar with Swami and Swami was warning not to take?
No, please carry on. Please tell. Okay.
One day we were all gathered in the bhajan hall and Swami didn't turn up for the darshan. So we were wondering maybe Swami is busy with some work or something. And just 10 minutes before we start the bhajan, there is some commotion, among the devotees. Then we knew that Swami is coming out of the mandir and coming for darshan. And Swami took a shortcut and came straight into the bhajan hall. And when he was sitting in the, when you enter the bhajan hall, and we know just another 5-10 minutes to start the bhajans. And Swami came and stood in one place and he was talking to a boy who is on the fourth or fifth row behind. And when Swami was talking, a boy who is in the second row, we are all tempted to touch his feet. And as whenever opportunity is there, we always want to do that. So this boy slowly made his effort and tried to touch Swami's feet. And Swami took one step backwards and Swami sternly looked at him and said, "No." And Swami continued his conversation with the other person who is on the fifth row. And after a few minutes again, when I told you, Swami is like sugar candy. Ants cannot keep quiet. We just try one more attempt. So this guy again, poor fellow, made one more attempt. And again, Swami was very upset and Swami sternly told him no. And this I observed sitting on the first line and I turned towards that boy and I signaled him. I told him, "Don't disturb Swami, not right." And when I was signaling to that boy not to do that, and Swami, while talking to the other person through the corner of his eye, he noticed what I am trying to signal to this boy. Anyway, I kept quiet. I thought I did the right thing. Swami won't mind. So I just kept quiet. And then later on what happened, Swami finished the conversation. He came straight and stood in front of me. And looking at me, he said, "Touch." I was wondering what touch. No, I was not mentally prepared. And then Swami again lifted his robe, showed his lotus feet, and he said, "Touch." Then before touching, I turned that side because just then I told that boy not to touch, don't disturb Swami. And here Swami is standing in front of me and asking me, "You touch." So I felt that boy, he will feel very bad. And I want to see his reaction. I turned and looking at that guy, and that boy was looking at me. He was wondering, let me see what Sai sir will do now, because he told me not to touch. Let me see what he will do. So again, I was, you know, didn't want to do anything, and smiling and looking at Swami. And Swami said, touch. And now it is a command. And you have to obey Swami's word. So I took my both hands and I touched the Swami's lotus feet. Lo and behold, it was hot. Swami's padam was very hot. Then immediately I looked at Swami. I said, Swami, it's very hot. And then Swami looked at me and told, yeah, from afternoon, a slight cold and the temperature is there. So that is why I did not come for darshan. I came late for darshan. I felt bad and I told Swami, you could have communicated to us why you should take all the trouble to come. If you have sent word, we would have started the bhajan, we will give aarti and we will get back to hostel. Why, Swami, you take so much time? And then Swami, with so much of love and, you know, smile on his face, and he said, you people, if you have a headache, you will write leave letter. If you are having fever, you will write leave letter. Or if you are tired, you will write leave letter. But he Sai Baba ku leave ledu. For the Sai Baba, no holidays at all.
There is no leave letter.
No leave. I can't apply for leave at all. And then Swami told, see, there are so many devotees travel hundreds of miles, and they just wait to have one glimpse. If they look at me, they look at my robe also, they are satisfied. They are very happy. So how can I deny? How can I refuse? And that is their devotion. Then I understood, we are very close to Swami, but we take things for granted. But there are people who come all the way, and you know, they just want to have a glimpse, not even a word or touch, just a glimpse. They feel they are satisfied and they're day sanctified and they're very happy. Now, these are the small things, you know, the lessons which bhajan hall trains us. Bhajan hall sometimes knocks at your mind and says, damn it, who you are, what you are, where you are, understand how much of a chance that Swami is giving you, and are you reciprocating in the same way? So that is how Swami sometimes would be very serious. And at the serious note, there is a message. There is definitely a message. At the same time, Swami will be doing a lot of pranks and jokes. Interview will get over. And Swami, you know, Swami's interview room, it's a magic room. If 6 people go, it will be full. If 16 people go, still it will be full. If 60 people go, still it will be full. I don't know how. It just absorbs like a sponge. And you know, Swami takes big group and spend 1 hour, sometimes even 2 hours with that group. And Swami is the first, Swami will be the last person to enter the interview room. And Swami will be the first person to open the door and come out of the interview room during those days. Okay. And when Swami came, Swami was fully sweating. The robe was wet. And Swami entered the bhajan hall. And in the corner, we used to have a table fan for Swami during the bhajan
time. Small fan in those days.
Small fan, yeah. And the Swami got up on that dais there, and then Swami signed me, switch on the fan. So I switched on the fan, but you know, that was not enough for Swami. It was here only, but it does not touching Swami's face. So I had to go behind and lift the fan and show on Swami's back and Swami's face. And Swami will turn left, right, like that he'll be doing. See, it's so nice that Swami is like another student, you know. He comes down to that level. At the same time, later on,
Mr. Prasad Rao Garu used to do that and sit there only.
Yeah.
He used to manage finally, the mic, so he would sit there.
Then
from there, he'll manage the mic and he'll hold the fan for Swami. Fan.
Yes. So like that, I think bhajan hall days are super days. Super days.
Sai, I remember you playing with your handkerchief, especially, you know, people, Giridhar, if I remember, Kumar, Giridhar, you in the front, you know, keeping Swami's handkerchief at the edge.
Yes, so
that
yes.
It falls down and you can pick it up and put it back.
That's just to get the chance. Just to get the chance. So they will keep it nicely, but we will try to adjust in such a way when this fan is on, it will slip and fall on Swami's lap, or it will come down. So we'll just pick it up and give it to Swami. You know, one-to-one contact. No, always students will always try to do something to get this attention. No, just getting that attention, getting a look, getting a smile, that day is done. That day is great day for us.
He used to manage the bhajans, when to stop, who will sing. He can plug people in, out, all that he would do.
Yes.
Sir, Sai, how do you look at it? He becomes so informal. Isn't it difficult? Did you ever find, for people like you sitting in the front row, did you ever find a challenge to remain conscious of him being the boss, the God? Sometimes you get fall prey to that playfulness of Swami and you may fall into that joking.
Yeah, sometimes it has happened. But I am always very careful when it comes to Bhagwan and this thing. And even when he jokes, the amount of laugh that you have to do got to be measured. That is, I've seen that. One day Swami was joking and the joke was so good and everybody laughed and I laughed loudly. And Swami is looking at me, seriously. He said, it is too much. Because Swami sees all other people are there. Ladies are there. Everybody is there. If you are inside the room, there is privacy. But in a public place, Swami always trains you to maintain that decency and decorum, yet enjoy the joke. So these are the small things, I think these things, we cannot put it in words, but it is part of your life where Swami teaches just by one nod, one sign, or one serious look. You get the lesson, you get the moral of the story. It has to be like,
you're right that bhajan hall was not just a bhajan hall for the students' community. No. It was everything. We have slept there, we have eaten there, we have used as a green room to change our costumes.
Yes,
we have been scolded there. Then the bhajan hall used to get locked up, and Swami would speak to you informally. So it was a bigger interview room in that manner. So Swami is, it was like a home for all of us that way. Isn't it beautiful?
That's why I put it as Swami, that bhajan hall is like a workshop for everyone.
Okay, let me ask you, because I'm sure you have been a student as well as teacher, so you might know the perspective differently. When Bhagwan, to teach us lesson or correct students, he would sometimes get very serious. And sometimes he will show his annoyance. He'll get very upset. Many times he would escape his darshan also. Before we could come, he will finish off the darshan. And if we come too early, then he will not even come. He'll come only for aarti and go back. So he has played us with all of that. As a student, we felt it differently. How was your understanding? What do you understand from that? How he teaches that lesson? When everybody gets into that whole community of students,
basket. Yes. In my observation in this scenario, if Swami is happy with one boy, just one boy out of 450 boys in the hostel, if Swami is happy with that one boy, everybody will get chance. Everybody will be happy, including the guest and the devotees also will feel very happy. If Swami is happy with one boy. The same thing with Swami's upset one or two boys, everybody will be in soup. And this happens, even devotees will be cursing. Why? Because Swami either will come late or he will not come, or he'll come early and quickly go off, or he may not call anybody for interview, or on the portico, upper portico, the VIPs will be seated. And Swami, because we are sitting in the bhajan hall, Swami will lock himself inside the interview room. He will not come out at all. And these guests and all will be sitting quietly, and Swami is inside the door, and these people are outside the door, and we are inside the hall. So the triangle series goes on. So everybody, I've seen this actually. But one thing, Abhi, you must understand is whenever Swami gets upset or whenever Swami becomes serious, it is always good for the students. There's nothing like selfishness or Swami deliberately doing. No, not at all. And Swami wants to teach a lesson through that boy as an instrument. He teaches lesson not only for student community, including devotees and those people who are in the portico. Everybody will receive at their frequencies the right message that they are supposed to get it. And Swami uses one boy as a trump card, you know, and one incident as a trump card. I've seen this many a time.
Any story you can recall?
One incident where I feel devotees, students, professors, and VIPs, everybody is involved in one incident. I will share with you that. You know, I always observe this from my student time onwards. You need to be careful with Bhagawan, especially three occasions. One, Ganesha Chaturthi period. When Ganesha Chaturthi is coming, something will go wrong. Somebody will tell something, or somebody will complain, or some boy will get caught on the wrong side. You know, Swami will wait for that opportunity and finish your smashed. It is not that boy is smashed, the entire group is smashed. Okay? It is always samatvam yoga muchate. Everybody is equal. There is no partiality in this. So we have to be very careful during Ganesha Chaturthi time. Second one is Dasara time. That when Egnam is going on, and last 3 days, no, you have to be very careful. He is like Shakti. And anything you try to ask, nothing will work out. Sometimes it go away. Sometimes you will get extra blessings where you never expected, something else will happen. So those Dasara time. And one more is Shivaratri. Shivatattva. He is damned, like Rudram. So this I have seen in these three occasions, people getting smashed. They are innocent. They open their mouth. They get madashed. They get smashed. I've seen later, I used to observe why this happens. But actually, Swami didn't mean anything. And Swami will always, after 2-3 days, Swami will, you know, sort it out and everything will become normal. And they will get the same chance, same importance, same, everything will be. But during that time, no, there'll be one bounce. The equation goes up and down and then it becomes stable. So I used to observe this many years and with many people. So during that time, I always seal my mouth. I will never ask anything. And if some boys come, no, I advise them, you waited so long, man. Just wait for 2 more days, man. Let Dasara get over, you ask, man. Let Shivaratri get over, you ask, man. Let Ganesha Chaturthi over, you ask, man. Don't ask now. And that fellows won't understand. He won't understand. Some people, Sai Sir, simply he will say, and then he will get up. The moment he gets up, Swami looks at him, sit down. Chupralo, Swami will say. Then that boy will not look at Swami, he'll look at my face. I said, Isliye main bulaya, just keep quiet. Yeah, you waited. With God, you have to wait. God is not instant noodles where you pray and it will happen. For that, there is time, there is situation, all that has to happen. So this I will tell you, on Ganesha Chaturthi time, I don't know, two boys, this is during my student time only, two boys, they just talk. They were conversing and Swami saw them talking from the window. That's all, nothing. This is the excuse, Abhi. Nothing blunder, no blunder. They have not done any blunder. They were talking, and Swami saw from the window these two fellows are talking. Next second, he came out. Appa, heavy leaking. Indiscipline. You people are waste. Why you should get seat here? Hey, warden, throw these fellows the luggage out. They don't need at all. This, that. So those two fellows, papam, they cried. They tried to understand what mistake they did. But ultimately, they understood that these two people were talking and Swami noticed somewhere. Okay. Then Swami sent word that, tell the boys, they need not come for darshan and bhajan. They come for studies. They didn't come for Swami. They're not following Swami's instructions. Only talking. Bad. Let them do bhajans. Let them study. Let them get certificate and go from the hospital. They don't have to come. They are not come for Swami, no. They come for studies. And then serious instructions is what? No darshans and no bhajans. So that was the last thing. And all our, we were all sitting in the bhajan hall, in the our dining hall. That is our bhajan hall also. And instead of doing bhajan the same time, we will be doing bhajans there. And then we thought it will get, you know, sorted out in 1 day, 2 day. No, nothing's happening. 2 days over, 3 days over. And here we have registrar coming, vice chancellor coming, and controller coming, and they will be advising boys, you have to be careful, you should please Swami, why do you upset Swami? They will come and give their own peace of mind to us, and we listen to all that, and then we do bhajans. And all this is the time, Abhi, our Prashanthi Nilayam post office revenue increases. You know why?
Everybody is sending telegrams.
They will not even send the register. See, they will not send ordinary post. If they send ordinary post will get mixed with the devotee's post. Now, devotee's post only per day, 2-3 gunny bags goes. And your letter will be part of one of the gunny bag, and so it's very difficult to catch Swami's attention. But if you send a register post, Swami will see who are the register. And if you want Swami to instantaneously see, telegram. So all our boys, they will send telegram, and our post office fellow, he knows, sorry, Swami, please pardon us, Swami. You know, that fellow is mugged up. He knows if you tell that, like in post office, you have code number, no, for birthday number 5, for something, you know, like that. And our man, he knows one code number, I think they can create, because this is a recurring thing happening. Every time this, you know, it recurs, it repeats. And Swami will see. Do you know what Swami will? Swami will not see the matter. Swami will see the name. Who are all the boys are responding? Swami will just flip quickly. 100 telegrams, 150 telegrams, 100 register posts. My God. So this is going on. And at the same time, we used to request our controller, our registrar, sir, on our behalf to pray Swami to pardon us. Even warden is not allowed, you know. If warden goes also, it will be a problem. Even warden is not allowed to go there. Warden also part of our batch. He'll be in the hostel only. So, like this, it went on. Then Ganesha Chaturthi came. Okay, it just, all this program, I told you, no, just before Ganesha Chaturthi, 4 days, 5 days before, the whole thing started. Now, Ganesha Chaturthi, usually Swami will call us, Swami will give big Ganesha statues, you know. He'll give one to primary school, Mandir, Isharamba school, general hospital. Swami will send one. And we thought, okay, Ganesha is a obstacle remover. So in the name of Ganesha Chaturthi, Swami has to give us idol. No. So he will call us. Swami will sort it out. That's what we had a great hope. Nothing happened. You know, Chiranjeev brought Ganesha and delivered. And Swami said, Swami has instructed us to give this Ganesha idol so that you can worship in the hostel. Swami doesn't want you to come to Mandir. You can do your prayers in the hostel only. And a serious note, you know, that's how, you know, the way Swami puts it, the same way he will finish this game. And he went off.
He was like that only. He would just deliver the message.
Deliver the message. Swami said, go on, slap, you will slap. You tell Swami told me to slap. Come on. Where is your chi? Attack. Finish. I did my duty. If anything, you sorted out with Swami, not with me. I tell you, that is dedication. Whatever it is. Okay. That is dedication. And commitment. Very difficult to live like that, Abhi. It's not. It's we laugh. For a person of that stature, with that authority, to live like that is highly impossible. Anyway,
both of them, I'm sure we are digressing, but both of them, like Kutumrao Garu and Chiranjeeva Garu, hats off to them. They are amazing personalities.
Swami trained them. Swami trained them. So finally, what happened? Okay, then we lost the game. And after 3 days, immersion ceremony. So we thought, okay, at least the immersion ceremony, Swami will give permission. And we sent word through registrar, we sent word through vice chancellor, we sent word through controller of examination, and we got the reply. What reply? Boys can directly take the Ganesha idol, and an opposite Sai Gita shed is there, their well is there, they can throw it and finish the immersion. They need not come to Mandir. That's a message for us. Oh my God. Again, we pleaded, we tried everything, and then somehow, we will not sit for bhajan. We will just take one quick round, one pradakshana of Mandir, and go back to well for immersion ceremony. Please, that at least they get the permission. With lot of deliberation, finally Swami agreed. Okay, I will not come out and let them do a pradakshana and they will go. They need not wait for me. They should not wait and they should not sit here. Just take one round and go back. Then we thought, okay, that is a very good opportunity. And that is the time our controller of examination, Mr. Nanjundaya, he called me, Sai, this is the only opportunity, man. I don't know what you guys will do. Do something and see that the ice are broken and you are back to square one, man, in Mandir. Even devotees are feeling bad that if boys are not there, Swami is not spending time in the portico. There's extra darshan. Devotees are not getting. Even devotees are feeling bad. And your VIP is also feeling bad because Swami will move around the devotees as above boys, joke and all that. Even that is also because Swami is locked up inside the interview room. Only for bhajansi will come, take arati and go. So it's going dry. Mandir is going dry in spite of Swami and devotees being there. So he told, I said, okay, sir, we'll see what we can do. And suddenly I got one idea. Then just before the procession starting, in the quadrangle, our old hostel, I called all the boys and I said, see, man, this is an opportunity. I got one idea. We will try this. All of us, what you do, when you enter the Kulwant, that time there is no Kulwant Hall, that's a normal. So when you are entering there, that time you walk slowly, like snail speed. Why? Because we have to spend maximum number of time in the Mandir. So you walk very slowly and see that everybody enters because we go ladies side and then other side and then come to the front of the Mandir. No, that's a circle that we do. So when you're coming that side, we enter the Ganesha gate and again we have to go back Ganesha gate only. So I told this idea and then I told I will be standing. I said, see, how whatever may be the condition, no, Swami will be inquisitive nature. Swami would like to see what all the types of Ganesha and how we decorated. Swami is inquisitive nature. Definitely he will be standing somewhere and then he will notice. If I happen to get that signal, I will give you one signal to all of you. What is that? Like this, I will say. That means what? All of you stop. I do like this. All of you will stop. Pin drop silence. So the bhajan, the vedam, everybody will be pin drop silent. And what you must do, just kneel down. All of you kneel down, except the boys, those who are carrying Ganesha. Pin drop silence. Kneel down. And I will show the direction wherever Swami is hiding and watching. Surely he will do it. And look at him and then you pray. Swami, please, please forgive us. Swami, you shout as loud as possible. We will see what happens. And see, already we are in trouble only. What more trouble can happen? Yeah. Come on, let us give it a try. Then everybody agreed. And as per the plan, everything went on very well. And Swami didn't come. Swami is not coming. And I think Swami is looking from his window somewhere. I don't know where, but I could not get him at all. Then finally, all this came. And then I told boys, as good as almost stopping and, chanting and singing bhajans. Then suddenly, the procession is not going. No, the procession is not going. So Swami, first floor, there are beautiful carvings are there. Like Gopuram carvings are there. In between, Swami put his head and trying to watch what is happening downstairs. See, Swami can hide, but Swami cannot hide his crown of hair. No, he can't hide his crown of hair. So Swami is hiding and watching, but his crown of hair was seen. So immediately I signaled to the boys. I said, Swami is here. And then that's all. When I did that, everybody was silent. Abhi, all the boys, professors, HODs, research scholars. Can you? I was standing where the bronze lion is there, no? To both sides, lion is there, no? I was standing there above my head only, Swami is there. And then all of them looking, I showed the indication, all of them looking that side. And then Swami, please, Swami, please, Swami. Abhi, the beauty was what, devotees joined. Even devotees joined to create more sound. They also said, please, Swami, please, Swami. And devotees are crying by seeing the boys' situation. I was watching everything, because I'm opposite to all the boys and the devotees. I'm watching what a scene it was. And, after all these things, Swami's heart is like a butter. It has to melt. correct? No, however hard he's trying to be, but inside is soft. And then immediately looked down and said, "Emi cheptunnaru? What boys are telling?" I said, "Swami, boys, they want you to pardon them and give them permission to come for bhajan." Swami said, "Oddu, oddu." Then immediately I signaled like this. Again, "Swami, Swami, please Swami, please Swami." My God. This went on, and then Swami gave a hearty laugh. Beautiful. You know, Swami opened his mouth and laughed. And then Swami said, "Tell them to finish the immersion and come for bhajan." Swami said. That is, you know, love of Bhagwan. That's why Swami says, "No, my love is 1,000 mother's love, not one mother's love." And after that, what happens? Ganesha palanquin was racing because we have to come back quickly. And they simply dumped the Ganesha inside and then quickly gave Arati. And then everybody started running back towards Mandir, because after 1 week, the eyes are broken. And then, you know, it is a sight to observe. There you see, what's the lesson? When you surrender to God without even a pinch of ego, I saw professor kneeling down. I saw HOD kneeling down. Elders, they're also equally kneeling down with their own students. And I saw devotees kneeling down and joining this group who is pleading with Swami. And when Swami observed this, you know, that's what, when you surrender, he will take over. So that is what I learned. And what I did was I stayed back and I told some boys to stay back and rest to come quickly. And next 3 minutes, Abhi, Swami came down and summoned Chiranjeevi Rao. "My boys are coming. Something I want to give. What do you have?" That time, no North Indian canteen, no Western canteen. Only our canteen only was there, no? Swami said, "Swami, laddu untai, laddu." Swami said, "Come on, go and get." So immediately he called 4 or 5 sevadals. He rushed to South Indian canteen and brought 4 or 5 basins of that bundi laddu. And then waiting for the boys to come. And when boys were joining, Swami was throwing laddu to each and everyone. That is the love of Bhagwan. That is why our boy Swami is so sweet, so kind, so loving. These are the sights I saw, I enjoyed. And really, it is very difficult to understand who is Swami. That's why Swami says, "Don't try to understand me, but be with me and enjoy." We have nobody to understand. We have nobody to gauge. We have nobody to assess or, you know, find who is Bhagwan. Best thing is to be with me and enjoy.
You know, Sai, you remind me that, you know, Vishad, as they say, Vishad Yog, the power of pain, the agony of missing God, agony of distancing from God, is the basis and not only the starting point, but the true conduit and a trigger for evolution.
Evolution.
And for that, God has to come down, play with us, make us fall in love with Him, and then give us those shocks of separation.
Pinch you, and then pinch you, and see how far you are mature.
How far can you go? Only when you get that taste, then the pain it pains becomes that agony, that the cry for God, that Vishad, and that is fantastic. But I'll tell you, today we are laughing about it. Today you are narrating, and we are having a laughing. That time it was
see,
not
the devotion. Actually, Abhi, during that time, no. When I sit and think now, hostel was pin drop silence. Everybody was. Some boys will be writing Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram, Om Sai Ram. Some boy will be sitting and doing meditation, and nobody will talk. There is no joke.
Wasted? How much food would get wasted? People will not even eat properly.
Yeah. So I think Swami once in a while just gives a kick in order to uplift our love and devotion to God. Somewhere it has to kickstart.
I think, and yeah, you're right. You know, everything which He does and He has done is only for our betterment, our improvement, and He has led it beautifully. Let me ask you another thing. You know, you have had privileges of traveling with Bhagwan. And that is also another, we have had few brothers who have shared their trips with Swami, how He was in the car, how he would jump out of the car and come into the bus with the boys. Mm-hmm. But the planning of the whole trip itself, I learned a lot of, personally, I learned a lot of management lessons from Bhagwan. The way he will plan everything. Even taking boys to Kodai, it looks very random. Okay, come on, let's go. But people hardly know how much of work it goes behind it.
Like backstage how he will
backstage work to plan it to the execution to the T, because he is a perfect host. Yeah. He is guest, but he's a perfect host. He's actually taking everybody. So can you give us some insight of that in your trips? Something to learn from Bhagwan, how he has managed those trips.
Yeah. I've been with Swami three or four times. I think this was, I don't remember the year. Sorry about the year. That was my second trip. The first trip was 1984-85, I think so. This is somewhere a little later, second trip. And Ruchir Desai and myself, Swami made us the in charge of the entire thing, myself and Ruchir Desai.
Yeah. And Ruchir used to go very often beforehand.
Yes.
Yeah.
So then our Swami's cook, Vishnu Bhatt Subbapaya and one more. Okay. And what happened was, Swami wanted to change the cot in our size in Kodaikanal.
Yeah.
So Swami prepared everything, and then Swami called me one day before, and then I went upstairs, and Swami explained to me. So many things are spread in that hall. Swami said, "This is pickle, this is ghee, and these are fruits. These are biscuits, and this is some savories, and these are sweet boxes. This is rice, like that. Everything, Swami, everything is displayed." And then Swami said, "I am sending my cot is in a very old cot, so I'm changing the cot. So one new cot will come, and then take that old cot and then send it back to V. Srinivasan's house, and this new cot you replace it there in Kodai." And then Swami called me and gave me one bundle, 10,000 rupees currency. And he said, "Tomorrow, 5 o'clock, you start. And I will get everything loaded into that closed truck." Natation, MG Road, Natation, handicrafts. Natation. It's a very, very nice devotee. And he sent that vehicle, closed vehicle. In that, everything was packed. And, Swami used to send his vibhuti, one big gunny bag of vibhuti packets, which is packed, because there also Swami, everywhere Swami gives interview, Swami gives prasadam. So the stock also have to go. So that was kept. And everything was arranged. And Swami gave me 10,000 rupees for your travel and for your food. And don't go same day. And you take a break and check into a hotel and see that the truck driver also eats food, and give him also food. Let him sleep in the truck only. And the next day morning, you start and reach by afternoon. No night travels with the luggage and all. It won't look nice. And Swami gave us the car. And car and a driver, everything. I'll tell you, Swami is so meticulous in planning everything. And then Swami gave me a bunch of keys. And then he took, this is the main door key. How beautiful, Swami, there are some 25 keys are there, okay, of different sizes are there. Now, this is my main door key, and this is the kitchen key. This is my room key. This is my cupboard key, and this is the guest room key. Like that, Swami showed everything. And then Swami showed, this is the storeroom key. In that storeroom, all the sleeping bags and everything will be there. You have to pull it out and go to the terrace and dry it, because for 10 months it is closed. No, because of dampness, it'll be moist, will be there. So put it in the sunlight, dry it, and keep everything ready. And after 5 days, I will come. So we are the pilot party. We have to go before and see that everything is arranged, everything, kitchens are cleaned, and everything is organized. We have to put the curtains and carpets and Swami's chair and kitchen vases to be washed. All the big job it is, actually. And Swami wants, nobody should be allowed only you people should do. Swami doesn't like anybody moving around and all. I said, yes, Swami. And that's how he gave money for our travel and for our food. And he gave the key bunch and he told me tomorrow morning start. So I took Namaskar. We started. We came here to Kodaikanal and we opened it. And that day night we stayed as usual. Next day we reached. When we opened the room, it was damp because all the windows, everything is closed. No, nobody stays there for a long period of time. And Kodaikanal, all the time it will be raining, dampness. So we opened all the windows and everything. And we went. I opened Swami's room. When I opened Swami's room, I was shocked to notice that above the ceiling, you know, the fungus is falling and the seepage of water because of heavy rain.
Oh my God.
The water tank is above Swami's room only. There is water tank. And, you know, there it got blocked and, you know, and they are full of water. And the water, there is nowhere to go out. So it is dripping through the ceiling, you know, like that it was. And I felt very bad by seeing Swami's room condition. And immediately I called the in-charge, an old man, Narayan, if I am right. And I told him I want one plumber, I want one painter, and I want all these people. And then we shifted everything outside. We got the whole room scraped and removed and, you know, painted twice and arranged everything nicely. And we replaced the old cot with the new cot. And Swami's dressing table, small dressing table. You know, Swami's room is always small. Everywhere it is small. The dressing table was somewhere else. So I thought that light is not enough. So I shifted that towards the, window, next to the window, so that Swami can see himself while combing, you know, like that. I reorganized a little bit, except for the cot, which Swami already kept in the same position. Rest everything I did, and then removed the, you know, old water and new water, over a tank, clean. Everything was done, and Swami came on the set time. By Swami's grace, everything was fine. So I put some frankincense before Swami comes and kept the door closed, put all the curtains, everything ready, including Swami's brush and this and that. Swami came, I opened the door. Swami said, I didn't say anything to Swami. Swami said, all okay? I said, yes, Swami. And then they gave Aarti. Then Swami straight went to his room. And then after 45 minutes, Swami comes down. He was so pleased and so happy. And he called all the guests and said, no one ever did job like this. See, the moment I enter, hot water was ready for me. The moment I enter, my room was smelling very good. And the new cot was there, new bed sheet was put. And after I washed my face and when I came, I saw my dressing table next to the window where a lot of light is there. I can comb my hair very nice. I said, so much. So nobody ever thought like comfort for me like that. Then Swami called me and they said, very nice, very good, very good. This Swami kept on speaking next 4 days to everybody, every guest. Napilalu, napilalu. I told him like chapati. Same like that. Swami used to, you know, a small thing. Actually, no, it is not a big task. Just rearranging things and making things clean and neat and comfortable. That's all it is. But Swami is not seeing that aspect. Swami is seeing something else with us. I think that is what I understood, that if Swami, you know, what we need to understand Swami is not this physical, but something little more deeper, little more intimate, that how you connect to him and how he connects to you in a divine perspective. And then I used to go for buying vegetable. Swami will call, whatever is for the kitchen, whatever they want, buy. So myself and Ruchir will take one car, they'll be there, one with one seva, then we go. And then, no, we used to ask Swami, Namaskar. Do you know, Swami will be sitting on the sofa, surrounding boys will be there. But you have to cross everybody to come. Do you know how Swami will give Namaskar? Swami lift his leg like that. And from far, I will touch and then take Namaskar. And the teacher also will touch like that. No, just fun. It is just fun, actually. It looks so nice, you know, that Swami, okay, come on. I lift my leg and take, touch me. Manchi vegetables, tiskura, good vegetables you bring. Like that. So we used to go to the shandy and buy all that. And, you know, living with Swami is a different feel. It is like walking on the razor's edge. It is like walking on fire. Because the distance between you and God is just the door and just the wall. Swami is the other room and we are in this room. So you can imagine how careful, how we have to conduct ourselves. We can't disturb Swami. At the same time, we have our own, you know, freedom, little bit of freedom. So Kodaikanal is a different experience. It's totally different experience for the student community whenever they go with Swami. And Swami is like a friend. It's like a friend.
It's very important for everybody to understand that, you know, whatever he did, even though seemingly small act or a fun act or a trip, he was always very meticulous, perfect. And he trained people accordingly because he expected the same thing from the students also and everybody for that matter.
100%.
Because when he goes out for darshan, his things have to be exactly ready.
Ready, yes.
You can't be. So it is that, you know, he has trained people in that manner. And that's amazing how much of effort is required. Here we had to train some 10 people, our whole life drains out. And he has been doing that for, I don't know how many generations he has done that physically. Yes. It's amazing. So Sai Sai,
one nice thing I want to share.
Sure.
Morning we used to have our bath and get ready, and we used to sit in front of Swami's room, and Swami will open his room and come outside, and we will all be seated. First darshan we used to have. One day, one boy, he used to do a lot of mimicry. He used to, a dog, a monkey, all that, you know, like that.
What
that boy wants to do? And, hey, sir, when Swami opens the door and come outside, can I, like a hen, co-co-co-co, can I do that, sir? My heart was in my mouth. I said, damn it, we just came. And if you do that, and if Swami gets upset to finish co-co-co-co, we'll all go out, man. No. Sir, rather to do it. I said, no, yeah, please think twice. And, you know, any moment Swami will open the door. You know, the tension. Any moment Swami will open the door. And this guy has got the teach. Sir, I want to do. I want to... morning wake-up call like that. Sir, please. I said, hey, tension, man, don't put me in trouble. Yeah, what to do there? Like, then finally, you know, that boy, when Swami opened the door, we were all sitting quietly and I was looking down. I don't want to look at Swami's face also. This boy, co-co-co-co, like that he did, loudly, exactly like a hen, you know. Then Swami, you're ready, with a lot of smile, no? So with, joy. Who is that? And then that boy, after doing that, he's also not looking at Swami. He's looking down. And everybody showed, because they don't want to get caught with Swami. No, they said, this boy, Swami. And then Swami, nu chesava, you did that. He said, yes, Swami. Ah, unko sari chai, do it again. Again he did. Ah, very nice. Do it again. So like that, 4 or 5 times, Swami made that fellow do that. And then Swami came out and, he told, see how boys are welcoming me from my bedroom when I'm coming. That is how they are calling like that. And that day evening session is mimicry session with this boy, how two dogs will fight. Okay. How donkey will bray. No, Swami was asking. And this boy was beautifully doing all that. That evening session was this only. It's an entertainment for even devotees and guests.
I heard about it. And the boy had mentioned that... He wanted to be Swami's Vidushak. He said, Swami, I want to make you laugh. That is my desire. I want to take a job of Vidushaka for you.
Yeah.
So Swami said, how will you do that? And then he said, Swami, I'll crack some jokes. I'll do some funny thing to make you laugh. So his only thing was that I want to become a person who can make you laugh.
Make you laugh.
When I heard it, I was so touched that, you know, somebody can think like that. That's... I only want to make him laugh. That is my job.
Yes.
Beautiful it was.
Intentions are good. That's why Swami also accepted that. Right? Any other person finished, you would have been sent out. You go outside on the road and do that. Somebody will give you some 1 rupee, 2 rupee like that. But you know, if your intentions are good and Swami accepts that.
You have to be literally, you know, pure and connected to that thought.
Connected. Yes.
The intent is so pure that I want to make God happy and smile.
Yeah. That is something.
For that, you can do whatever, you know.
Yeah. These are some of the beautiful things, you know, live performance and, you know, being part of it and enjoy that. And really, Abhi, you really understand Swami. See, when we feel God means somewhere we put in a high pedestal, no? But when he is moving with you, that is why Swami says, no, when I am among men, I am men. Among women, I am women. Among child, I am child. Among children, I am a child. You know, that is true actually. That is how Swami also behaves. Swami also responds to people's love and devotion.
Beautiful. So, sir, when you became a teacher, or let's hear, was there any adventure in becoming a teacher? How did you get the role of teacher? Happens with Swami's instructions, obviously.
Yeah, so, I finished my BCom. We were the first batch. Only degree was there. Then when we are in the final year, we told Swami, what is next? And Swami said, PG cheyandi. I said, Swami, PG ikkada ledu. No, who said ledu? And then, you know, Swami immediately called. Then, you know, VK Gokak was the vice chancellor. And then that's all. When Swami says, nothing waits. So within 6 months' time, they did all the paperwork and they started off. And then MA, MCom, and MSc. These three started. MBA was not there during our batch. MBA was not. Only MCom, MSc, and MA. These are the three PG courses started. So I joined MCom and 2 years got over.
US was the first batch of MCom and mine was the last batch of MCom.
Okay. MBA started just then.
MBA started and MCom got over.
Which year is yours, last batch?
1990.
From 91 onwards, MBA started, huh?
No, MBA started 86.
Uh-huh.
There is an overlap of two years with MBA and MCom going. And then they said there's no point because the syllabus was same and, you know, so everything got, and MCom got disappeared and we are the last person to do the course.
Last batch. So that's how, then I completed my MCom and then some of us, we applied for PhD. Even I applied for PhD. My synopsis was priority sector banks. Private banks, priority sector. That time, agriculture, some priority, something was going on. So I gave my synopsis, and we were 6 or 7 of us. We applied in university for a PhD. And just then, in higher secondary school, there was one vacancy for in the commerce department for commerce teachers postgraduate teacher, and they wanted BCom, MCom is a qualification that is needed, and so they thought I will be the ideal person because. Access to Swami is there, and you know, we can also, you know, that is how people look at those times. They asked me, I said, see, I have no plans. I've applied for PhD. If Swami tells me, definitely I will join. I have nothing. Whatever Swami says, I will do. Then they went, and that time Professor Habu was there, and Shivaram Krishna was the vice principal, and Professor Habu was there. So they went and told Swami. And Swami said, Mire Adagandi, you go and ask. And they came and told me, Swami is telling your wish. Then I said, no, it is Swami's wish. So this went on for 4 or 5 days. And then one day, it seems Swami told them, see, if he is having the intention that he wants to do PhD, how can I stop him? I don't want to stop him. That's why Swami says his wish. And for me, Swami only paid my money for food and everything. Swami is taking care. Who am I to say I want to do this? I don't want to do this. I am nothing. So I said, whatever Swami. Swami made me study. If I am today BCom, MCom, it is because of Swami. Whatever Swami says, I will. So the ball was bouncing up and down. These two people were going inside the interview room, coming outside. And then one day, Habu went and cried, Swami, classroom is empty, teachers are not there, and finding it very difficult to handle. Please, Swami, do something. And that day, I was sitting outside and in the portico. Swami came straight to me and asked, "Hey, higher secondary school lo upanyasam istava?" This is the word he asked. Upanyasam istava. He didn't say teaching or anything. Upanyasam istava. He said. Then I looked at Swami. I said, "Swami, whatever you say, I will do." Atla kadu, nee uddesham emi? What is your opinion? Then I told Swami, whatever you say, I will do. That is my opinion. I don't have anything else in my mind. If you say, do this.
Translate the first line. He said, Swami asked you, would you teach in higher secondary school?
Higher secondary school. Will you teach in higher secondary school? Will you teach in higher secondary school? I said, Swami, whatever you say, I will do. No. What is your idea? I said, I have me uddesha meme. I said, nothing in my mind, Swami. Whatever Swami says, I will do. Your wish is my, I will do it. That's all. I will take that command and I will do it. Then Swami said, I know. And Swami patted me. I know. Swami said, hey, Abu, like that Swami called. Then this man came running. See, Monday, 7:39 Rao Kalam. Monday is a good day. And he will come after Rao Kalam to your school. No interviews, no procedures, nothing. Give him the textbook, show him the classroom, and you also don't be there. You just walk out. He will take care. That's what he told. Then Habu felt very happy because he wanted a teacher. Okay, whatever it is, now this boy, person is coming. He said, yes, Swami. And then Swami gave me namaskar and said, Monday onwards, you join. I said, okay, Swami. So Monday morning, I sat. Swami gave me namaskar. And our professor Habu was waiting near the main gate because I will be coming now. So I came here around 9:15, 9:20. And he was having... As Swami said, no, he was having NCRT textbook in his hand. And he gave me and took me to, I think it is B floor or C floor, I don't remember.
C floor.
He took me there and then he introduced to the boys, this is your commerce teacher and he will be taking commerce from today onwards. And he said, sir, you can take, and he walked out. No interviews, no nothing, no order, beader, nothing. Just straight walking and I started teaching. And
no, evening, that is 84, right? 84, 85.
84 June. Yes.
Yeah, 84, 85 batch, right? Yeah, yes, that was my class. That was my class.
Yeah, 84 is yours, sir. You were in 12th class that time?
Yes.
Or 11th? You were in 12th, huh? 12th. You and I think he's in Adblock. What is his name? Ravi is 1 year junior. Krishna. Adblock is Krishna. Yeah, K. Krishna.
He's junior. Yes. He was probably in 11th. So
no, K. Krishna.
You must have taught both the classes, right? At that time, yeah, 11th, yes, and 12th.
11th and 12th. Yeah. I started. Harish Mirpuri.
Yeah, we were only for a few days, a few months.
Singer Ravi Kumar was in class that time.
So you that joined how, that way.
That is how I started. That's how I was nailed here. And 35, I think now 36th batch is going on.
Let me show you some pictures of school. Maybe that will help you to, narrate to us some nice stories of that. And that will help us to take your journey.
Oh, this this picture is in B floor for sports prize distribution ceremony. We invited Swami, and Swami came to our school after discourse, just before Aarti. Subbarao sir is having Aarti plate, see there. And this is our school coconut tree, tender coconuts. And
we had made a small garden behind.
Mm-hmm.
And this was the first fruit which had come out.
So I took that and then with the straw, and Swami, having matchbox in his hand, see, just before lighting the aarti, he's having matchbox also in his hand.
Yeah.
And he took 2-3 sips like that. And then he said, enough.
That is Mr. Rao and that is Ved Narayan, sir.
Ved Narayan, yes. That is after Swami's discourse.
No? If you look at it, you are inviting God. And look how simple. He just took a coconut and directly and he's taking a big sip on it. I tell you, it is such a lovely experience to remember also.
Mm. This is our... we used to conduct an exhibition. We conduct Swami's photo exhibition and science exhibition. We started it. Actually, school started many things first. For your information, Vedam, teaching Vedams, school only started.
Yes.
Christmas carols.
After us.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Christmas carols, school only started.
School.
Okay. Science exhibition.
Agarbatti making.
Camphor making. going to Sanatana Saradhi, you know, making a book,
press,
Sanatana
yes.
Saradhi press, we used to go there.
Yes.
No, so many things actually school initiated first. And this was the science exhibition. And we invited Swami to come. And Swami, after morning bhajans, he came. And, you know, that was the time the solar concept started, solar energy, right? So this guy who is sitting here, no, he made a model and he wants to, this is the solar panel he made here. And Swami is asking what, and I am explaining, Swami, that boy made the solar panel, and in few seconds, the water will get heated up, I told. Unfortunately, when I was explaining, cloud came. And Swami waited. Hey, yemi raledu, Swami was telling. You know, sometimes, you know, with a lot of enthusiasm, we try. And then finally, Swami is asking, etla utundi, how it will happen, Swami is asking. And I'm trying to explain the process or procedure. Very nice. Because this
nice,
unit,
you know,
only
memories.
this unit is outside. The rest of the science exhibition is inside, because this needs solar energy, no? That is why this unit is outside. The rest, everything is inside.
Yeah.
One boy made a bugler alarm.
That. You can tell that. But let me finish this, sir, because I want to highlight some faces here. That is Dr. Shivram Krishnaiya, sir, who is the principal,
yes,
current principal of the school.
Current principal, yes.
And this is Mr. Habu.
Yes, Habu.
A gem of a man, gem of a man.
Mm.
Karunananda Garu.
Yes.
A great saint in his own standing, but an ardent devotee of Bhagawan. And that is Vednarayan, sir. People know him very much. And that is you.
And there is Ramon Rao also. Next to Vednarayan Rao. This is Ramon Rao.
Oh, here is Ramon Rao. Yes,
that is Ramon Rao.
And this is a batch of Katta Bhaskar. So I see Katta Bhaskar.
Yeah, Katta Bhaskar is there. Yes.
Okay. So they are that batch of boys.
That batch students. Yes. This is, I think this is Rishi Sheth, if I am correct. No, it looks like Rishi Sheth.
No, it's like Rishi. Yeah, it looks like. No, it is Bhardwaj. Slightly. Rishi Bhardwaj.
Rishi Bharadwaj, and this is Arunesh Punita. Am I right? This looking like Arunesh Punita, if I am right. I don't know.
I can't make out. Yeah, I think the
can't
Gopal
make out, yes.
It looks like Gopal.
Mm-hmm.
And this is from Jakarta, is this boy.
Yeah, from Indonesia, that boy.
Indonesia, yes.
Mm. Yes, yes.
Wonderful memories. So you're telling about that burglar alarm. You can tell that story.
This unit is outside because it needs sunlight for demonstration. The other one is, we have two floors. This is a beautiful one. Yeah, show me that picture.
Yeah, and you can finish the burglar alarm story also.
Yeah. We made a dart for throwing. And that boy will have on the tray here. And then Swami asked what? Swami, exactly in the center. We are, this I have done. Even my young days also I have done. I can do it, Swami was telling. And, you know, without much effort or anything, you know, immediately he picked up one and he threw it. Lo and behold, exactly in the center, it fell. Exactly in the center. Okay. So that was very nice, actually. One shot only. One shot, it was in the center. That one. We put one thermocol sheet and three circles. And we pasted that on the wall. The distance is around maybe 6 feet, 7 feet distance, and the Swami did the job. Fantastic. It was very nice. And after this, Swami went to a burglar alarm. And that boy was explaining, Swami, this is burglar alarm. And if you keep the hand, it'll beep. And then he demonstrated. He put his hand, then immediately beep, 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 beep. It was coming. Then one guest, you know, along with Swami, those people are there, no guest. So Swami told, put your hand. And that guest also put his hand. Again, he said, beep, 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 beep. And then Swami saw all these people. They got tempted and everybody was trying. And then Swami thought he will also do that. And then boy also said, Swami, you put your hand, Swami. You put your hand, Swami. And then Swami put his hand, silent.
Nothing happened.
Nothing happened. Then that boy thought some connection problem. So again, he connected batteries, this and that he did. He put his hand, beep, beep, it was coming. Now, Swami, now it is working. Swami, please, you put your hand. Swami put his hand, it was silent. So this happened 2-3 times. And then the boy, you know, he got confused. He didn't know why that is happening. And then Swami said, "You are all thief. I am not thief. That is why it will not beep," Swami said. Then all laughed. "I am not a thief. You are all thief. That's why when thief put hand, it will beep. I am not a thief. It will not beep," Swami said. A beautiful.
But he made a statement like Chittachura or something, no?
Something he said.
Something. He said, "I'm not an ordinary thief which will be caught. I'm Chittachura."
Chittachura, yes, something like that.
"I'm not ordinary thief like you. I'm a Chittachura. I steal the hearts, so you can't catch me with these instruments."
These are all beautiful. live demonstrations of Swami, I should say that. And this is our prize distribution ceremony, where our college auditorium, Swami used to tell us to use for school prize distribution. Those days, institute prize distribution and school prize distribution separate, a different time. Swami used to come there, and we used to organize that. And then I'm welcoming Swami. And during this time, every time, you know, school prize distribution, Swami is always happy, because on the stage, we used to create something very new. We used to create waterfalls, and we used to create a globe rotating with our limited resources. These are all our backdrops. We used to do like that a lot. And this is on the stage before the prize distribution. And that's a globe behind, called Sat Chakravarti. And this is the time when we were inviting Swami to the stage. I gave rose petals to all the boys, right from the main entrance till the stage. And you know the path. And the Vedam boys, I told Vedam boys, you must give gap between Swami and your group. And the Vedam boys was, you know, pitching front, and there is a gap. And every boy was kneeling down, and handful of rose petals, you know, they were throwing just before Swami is putting his leg, you know, like that. I told them, don't put on Swami's leg, but before Swami puts his leg, he should walk on the rose petal, not on the floor. That is my concept. So I told and I explained, and boys did exactly the moment Swami came, because the concept is Sat Chakravarti. There is nobody above him. He's the greatest. So with that concept, we welcomed. Swami sat, and in his discourse, he was telling, "No one ever invited me like this. Right from the beginning till the stage, all the boys, they threw rose petals, and I walked on the rose petals, and they invited me so beautifully. No one ever invited me like this." And Swami mentioned that. So this is, I feel that a small thing, but no, it goes somewhere, you know, Swami feels very happy.
He's sweet enough to acknowledge even the small feelings and expressions.
This is Swami's drama. Swami wrote a drama, you know, Cheppinattu Chestara, where Swami, when he was young days, you know, he had written, and you know, all that drama got translated into English by Sundarai.
Do what you say.
So here we have, "I am the father."
There is
S. Kumar was my wife. And
there is Sundarayya.
That is Sundarayya. He was the teacher. And here you find this boy. V. Srikant is my son. He's my son in the drama. And a nice drama.
I think this drama was very popular. He has been doing it himself also. When he was a small kid, he has written it.
Yes.
So he repeated it quite and often, that Cheppinattu Chestara.
Even this drama, Swami repeated twice with the same actress. Two times we staged there on the same Purnachandra Hall. Twice it happened. This is our convocation music program.
Second convocation.
Yeah, second.
Wow.
Yes. Second convocation music program, and
that is Durjati.
Yes,
who we brought for sharing. That is Sonam Kote, yes. Brother.
Yes,
Jogi Raju.
Jogi Raju, Hariharan.
Hiros, yes. Brother.
Yes.
Wow, that is a very old memories.
old memories. Yes,
and Swami that gave is a us sports day picture, I believe, right?
Yes. This is a sports day picture. Teachers' sports meet also. School only started first. See, those days, what happened? No, anytime, any program. No, we are supposed to go and invite Swami. So our boys' sports meet going to start. Institute people went and prayed Swami, and Swami blessed. I said, I will come for the sports meet. And from school side also, we have to go. It's like mandatory. No, we have to go and invite Swami for the boys' sports meet. So boys made a beautiful card, and all the teachers, we went morning bhajan time. And just before bhajan, Swami came out. He saw us, but he did not tell anything. He went inside the bhajan hall. After we were seated there only. After bhajan, Swami came out, and then Swami asked, "Kya samachar? Why you came? School is going on. Why are you all here?" Then our Habbu told Swami, "We are inviting you for the sports meet, Swami. Please visit us," like that. Swami said, sports meet. Very good. When? All that Swami was asking. Some conversation was going on. Only students sports meet? Teachers ka sports leda? There is no sports for teachers. Only teachers will teach. Only sports for students? Then immediately we said, Swami, if you want, we can have for teachers also. Then we asked Swami, when? Aaj. Aaj karo. Abhi karo. So we are wondering, teacher sports now, Swami? Yes, now. So now bhajan is over. I will have my lunch and I'll give 1 hour's time. I will come to the ground. We'll have teacher sports now, Swami said. And then Swami gave namaskar to all of us and he went inside. My God, quickly we came and we told all the boys to organize things. And immediately, some boys with the help of PT, they drew the white lines for running race. Some boys went to the kitchen and got gunny bags for 3 rack sack race. And some boys got spoons for lemon and spoon race. Like that. Some boys got this. So everything was quickly organized, all these things. And I remember Swami's guest was Justice Bhagavati. Swami brought Justice Bhagavati in Rolls-Royce car. I remember that. Rolls-Royce car, Justice Bhagavati, and Radha Krishna. And only these people came to the ground. That time we never had Shanti Vedika, Those days,
no, ground on the steps.
Yeah, two levels. So yeah. This is where Swami, you can show the picture, is where that is a ladies' gallery. Now present ladies' gallery.
Yes.
And there we put a small shed like thing, and Swami sat there, and then teachers started running. And
the idols today, all the, Jesus,
yes,
Buddha,
yes.
just in front of the idols. There is a stairs. Steps which are ladies today, that had a stage actually.
Yes. And basically it is ladies gallery. You can say ladies gallery. Now. Middle of the ladies gallery now.
And for the sports day, you had items like tug of war.
Tug of war we had.
Musical chair.
Yes.
And lemon and spoon race.
Lemon and spoon race. Three-leg race. Sack race. And, all the... We had many elders also. 50 years, 60 years. Even they also ran. They did, according to the age we organized. See, everything was planned in just a matter of 1 hour, Abhi. Everything was planned. And the best part was breaking the pot. That is the ultimate breaking the pot. That is Habbu sir's idea. And what he did, he brought a pot, and one person will be given a long stick, and he'll be made to stand straight 10 feet away from the pot, and he'll be made to see that and give a long stick, and then take a kerchief and make him blindfold, and then rotate him 3 times and leave him. And now, without seeing, he has to go straight and hit that pot and break it. That's called breaking the pot. Oh my God, the pot will be on one side and this professor or teacher, whoever it is, he'll be on going left side or right side, away somewhere and all, they will be going. And Swami was looking at that and laughing. That time we had this Padmanabhan, Padmanabhan is a beautiful photographer, official photographer also those days. He took all those snaps. Those are the best snaps taken by Padmanabhan those days. And, Swami enjoyed thoroughly. Some of us fell down. We had a little bit of injury here and there, scratches here and there. And Swami enjoyed. That was the first teacher's sports meet by seeing this that day evening. Immediately all the professors, you know, university people, Swami, please come for our sports meet also, Swami. And then it became clubbed. It became a one show.
Yeah, we can take credit of it, because formally the sports happened in Anandpur campus, and then it came to Prashanti together. But in our campuses, school was the first person to do the sports.
Teacher day. Sports.
No, even that, student sports.
Yes.
Yeah, and yes, then yes, teacher correct. Sports day. And then everything happened, you know.
Then only university started. Yes.
Beautiful. Sai sir, Swamis, if you like, more and more we think about Bhagwan, you know, you find there is nothing which he has not, an aspect of life that he has not touched upon.
Yes,
Bhagwan has absolutely. Touched upon everything in life. And the most amazing thing which I find is that he has lived every word he has spoken. So he has led it, you know, directly.
Yes.
And he keeps his word when he says, no, this is like truth. My name is Satya and my acharan is Satya. So
Satya is my prachar.
My prachar and acharan. See, so powerful that nothing, even a jokingly, no word is uttered without any purpose. So imagine that strength. Can you share some experience of how he keeps his words, you know? Even after years, we don't know the timeline when it get manifested sometimes. But
you want the serious part, you want the comedy part.
I would like the comedy part a little bit, but choice is yours.
Okay,
I leave it to you. No problem.
Yeah. So this is actually Victor Craxi, you know, from Italy. He's a very staunch devotee. He in 1980 or 81. We are still not shifted to our hostel. We were still staying in Mandir only, all of us. And he brought one car, that time Benz car, the latest model of 1980. One green color Benz car he brought. And before that, he was there in the portico. We were all, you know, darshan time. Swami, hey, when did you come? Swami, I came yesterday only, Swami. How is everything? All fine, Swami. And then he said, Swami said, what? Swami, I brought a small gift for you. Gift? For me? Why? I don't need gift, Swami said. No, Swami, please, Swami, accept. What gift? Swami asked. Swami, I brought one car for you, one Benz car, the latest model, Swami. Hey, I have so many cars. Why I need this car? No, Swami, please, Swami, please, Swami. Keep quiet. Sit down. And Swami gave him namaskar and walked out. And this gentleman had been praying for almost a week. Every time when he says, Swami, you will kneel down. Swami, please accept this gift. Swami, please accept. Swami always said, shut up, sit down, like that. Swami was. We all felt very bad. Are this man sincerely is asking, not one day, continuously for a week, why Swami is so rude to him? What is wrong if Swami accepts, you know, or make him happy like that? Now, we used to feel very bad. And then on one day, Swami came again. He was kneeling down and asking. Swami asked, where is the car? Then he said, Swami, car is outside. Swami said, bring the car. So he brought the car. And then Swami called Radha Krishna. And then this gentleman bought one new car, it seems. So let us go for a drive. Then Radha Krishna took the key and he went and started the car. And then Swami came to that slope. You know, again said that slope is there. And they're all, everywhere boys will be seated, right? And Swami stood and watching the car, and car came in front. And Swami looking at the boys, Swami said, So all boys didn't understand what he meant by Then again Swami said, like that he did, like this, he did. Still boys could not get the idea. Then Swami took his hand and said, go to the car. Just then, you know, boys thought, oh, Swami wanted us to get into the car. So all boys ran and got into the car. And, you know, in front seat, two boys sat. One fellow sitting on each other lap. And behind, four fellows got into that. One fellow sitting on each other lap. And gave a small place for Swami to sit. And, you know, that time Kaldas used to be there. You know, he opened the door and Swami sat. And then he closed the door. And Swami on one side and Radha Krishna diagonally that side. A friend to two boys and behind four boys, and the car started. So we all felt very happy that, these guys are so lucky. They got the chance to go with Swami in the new car for a drive. 15 minutes over, 20 minutes over, we were all waiting for Swami. And then finally, 25 minutes, car came back. But car came empty. Only Swami and Radhakrishna was there. Swami was sitting behind, Radhakrishna was driving. So we were wondering, where are the boys? So Swami got down from the car and looking at us, you are all thinking, where are the boys? No. Anyway, from here, it is already time for college. You have to go to college. I told you, our college is Ishramba school upstairs, first floor. Anyway, you have to go there. So if I bring them, poor fellow, they have to walk. So I dropped them there and then came. So we all laughed and kept quiet. Okay, that day is over. Then next day again, Swami came. And whenever Radha Krishna comes first, that means it is an indication Swami is going out. That is our indication. If Swami comes out first, that means a regular darshan and interview. If Radha Krishna comes out first, means it is Swami is going out somewhere. So Radha Krishna came first. When Radha Krishna came first, again Swami came and the same car came and stood there. And Swami stood in the same place and said, Now we all know what is means. Now again, everybody ran and some boys got into the chance. And I was somewhere deep inside. I was wondering, sir, these guys are going again. And some of them are pushing and pulling. I always feel that in front of Swami, you should behave properly. But these guys, pulling and pushing each other's shirt and there is mud. They will fall. Their pant will become red color. Their shirt will become red color. And then Swami was laughing and enjoying that fun, falling in front of him and getting into the car and all that. Then third day, I felt I am a fool. So thinking of too much of discipline, you are losing the chance of going into the car. Then I thought, why not? I will also try. So the next day, I tried. I also tried them. Now, what happened? Next day, darshan, nobody will be sitting near the interview room door. Full crowd will be on the slope only. Why? Because everybody wants to get into the car. The car is more important than Swami's darshan. One day, Swami came out and asked, Pillal ekada, where are the boys? Then Kailda was telling Swami, they're all behind. Then Swami peeped, oh, they're all waiting for the car. We used to have maja time, lovely time, I'll tell you. Student time with Swami was amazing time. I hope if Swami comes out again and
this is Radha, Radhakrishna. Here he's sitting.
He is Radhakrishna. Excellent driver. So what happened was
amazing boy.
Very dedicated person. Very dedicated, very humble, very helpful, soft spoken. He's from Ooty. Very nice person. And his brother and myself only, we studied together. Tamil. You know that episode of Tamil?
Yeah.
That you remember. Okay, fine. Then that day I also ran, man. But, these boys have got 3 days practice. And that was my first day. They pushed me down. I fell down. And Swami looked at me and laughed. And, by then car is full. Car went off. So I patted my shirt and came back and sat. The next day I thought, this is not the right way. We should also try our strength to fight with the boys. We should be unruly in front of Swami. Don't worry whether discipline or indiscipline. So next day I also tried. Somehow, to my surprise, I was inside the car. Do you know how I was inside the car? My left leg was inside. My right hand was inside. And my half body was inside the car. The other leg is outside the car. Like Ardhanarishwara. Half the body was inside the car and half the body was outside the car. Because already 4 guys are already seated, gave a little place for Swami to settle down the other side. So I was telling, please, hey, little bit adjust, man. Hey, if you little bit adjust, I'll put this leg inside, yeah. Then Kaldas can close the door, yeah. Please. That was saying, no pressure, where you are. So this was going on. Swami, that side he came, he sat, his side door was closed, and this door is not closed. Radha Krishna cannot start the car. So Swami was wondering why the car is not starting. And then Swami peeped and said, he understood the situation. And he looked at me and told, oh, place ledu. Oh, yo papam. You get down. Unko turi pilchukaltanu. Now you get down. I will take you on another day. He said. Who told? Baba told. What he told? You get down now. I'll take you another day. I said, okay, fine. So I myself royally came out. Decently, I myself closed the door. I was the only guy returning back from the car and all were laughing. I said, doesn't matter. Yeah, you did not hear what Swami told. Swami said, I will take you another day. So next day I was sitting like this, like a big gentleman. I was under the intuition, impression that Swami will call me first. Hey, you go. And then he will say, you know, I was thinking of that level. So Swami came, stood next to me. He said, everybody there. And car was full. And I was like, Swami, you told me that you will take me. What happened? You didn't tell me at all. That's all I thought. Finish. Swami cheated me. I kept quiet. And that was the last day. You know, the engine got heated up and some trouble with the car. You know, the car was used like a lorry where six fellows inside and all. I don't know what happened. So some problem, technical problem with the car. And then that it went on for almost 4 or 5 days, this giving chance. The boys will get dropped in the Ishrama school and come back, you know. And that was lost. Then I forgot about it. Then I thought, my bad luck, and I am not getting this chance. 1980, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85. Okay, 5 years. I was going in a cycle. I was teacher. Just then I joined as a teacher, and I was going in a cycle. The previous day it rained, and there is a lot of sand came out from the primary school, and it is on the road. Those days, no, roads are all very slow and narrow road. Now it is wide and big. And I was coming from in the cycle. I was coming, Ram Mohan Rao cycle I was taking. One of my colleague was not well, chemistry teacher. So I that time only Ganesh Bakery, only one bakery in front of Ganesh Gate. And he was the only supplier for even hostel, bread, biscuit, rusk, buns. Only from him only we used to get. So he is having high temperature. So I took Ram Mohan Rao cycle. I bought some bun. I took some milk packet and milk and all that. I was coming, and Ram Mohan Rao cycle handbar was bent inside. So my long legs are long. So my left leg just touched that, and like a steering wheel in that slope, you know, that arch is there. That slope is very steep. Those days, very steep. Now it is reduced because road after road, it has leveled upwards. So it rotated and I fell. One side, bun and, you know, biscuit, and other side, you know, these things. And like Hanuman, I was just flying down and fell on the middle of the road. Exactly, I fell between the primary school gate and this side is the college gate. And those days, no traffic, no. Only KSRTC bus and SRS bus will come. No vehicles those days. Bullock cars only, you know, 1980s, nothing much. So the road was empty for me to fall. I fell, and then the cycle behind me rolled, and the hand, the pedal hit my leg, and a piece of flesh just came out. And then immediately, you know, I felt very ashamed. I saw left and right. Road was totally empty. Nobody saw. But one English professor was coming from the college towards the gate. I think he saw the entire my circus happening on the road. Then I got up. I saw my bone, white bone, okay? That's because the flesh went out. The next second I saw the blood was gushing out. So much of blood. I think the moment I saw the blood, I think I fainted. That much only I remember. But when I opened my eyes, I was in the general hospital. Alraja was standing next to me. Two nurses were there. And my leg was fully put crepe bandage, and they tied it. Then I asked the doctor what happened. No, nothing much. Hairline fracture and, you know, ligament rupture. So you have to take rest. Sir, if Swami comes to know that I am riding cycle and I fell down, Swami will take me into task, sir. Please, I have to go for evening darshan. I will tell Swami I fell down, but I have to go for evening darshan. No, don't worry. I have already informed Swami. I told Swami that you fell down in cycle, and Swami gave me Vibhuti Prasadam, and he gave me 5 Vibhuti packet. I said, what, sir? So soon you already set fire to Swami. I said, no, I have to tell Swami. I have to report to Swami. I have already told Swami, and Swami gave me Vibhuti packet. Anyway, finished. So I am on the wheelchair, and I was taking class in the hostel. I cannot go. And those days, every time after Swami's lunch, you know, Swami is to move around in the car to Enumanapalli circle. He used to take one round and come. And that is the time Suri Narayana and our kitchen in charge, Venkatachalam, they used to give me hand, helping hand, and I will be sitting near the gate, main gate, road. Opposite was Mango Grove. Now we have International Stadium. that time it was Mango Grove and Sai Geeta's residence, opposite gate. Yes. So Swami car will come, Sai Geeta will come that side, and myself this side. Swami will put the glass down and bless that side Sai Geeta and this side me. And then he'll have a word or two. Sometimes he'll open the door and show his leg. I used to touch and take namaskar. Like this, it was going on. Nice, very good chance. I used to get one-to-one like that. One day, Krishna Janmashtami was coming. And during Krishna Janmashtami, you know that cow procession is there. All that will happen. So Hyderabad group has come to do a performance in front of Swami. And also our Gokulam procession. So I went, Swami asked, will you come? I said, yes, Swami, I will also come. And I went in cycle rickshaw. Those days only cycle rickshaw, auto rickshaw was not there. So I sat in my place near the bhajan hall. Swami came out, Swami saw me sitting and full crowd. Swami told Kyle Das to put a plastic chair. He put a plastic chair and I sat on the chair and I was watching the entire cruising. That time, no, peacock dance was there. Very nice peacock, the Hyderabad group was doing. Then all that is over. Swami went to Sai Geeta, fed Sai Geeta. Swami went to cows and gave banana. Everything got over. Swami took Arati. The procession went back. Then I have to get back now to hostel. So I thought if I go in the cycle, it won't look nice. Those days, no, Swami won't like any student seen on the road when he's on the car, when he's coming on the car. That is why if suddenly if we come to know Swami is coming, we run to tailor shop or provision shop and hide ourselves because you can't. You get scolding from Swami. So we used to do that. So I thought, well, I'll wait for some time. After Swami goes and comes, then I will go. So meanwhile, Swami finished his lunch. He came outside. I was the only guy sitting at the entrance of Bhajana Hall. Swami looked at me and said, you're not going to hostel? He said, Swami, I will go, Swami. How will you go? I said, Swami, cycle rickshaw will come. He will take me to the hostel. Why cycle rickshaw? Anyway, I'm going. Hey, Radha Krishna. Hey, Kalidas, help him. And those two gave me support. And I was, jumping. And Swami was coming behind. And that is the red car, Ada 9. You know that picture, you can show that picture. In that car, Swami sat behind. And I was made to sit next to Swami. And Radha Krishna was driving. And C. Srin was in front. They were only four. No crowd. Absolutely no crowd. And the glass went up, the door closed, cool breeze, beautiful aroma, God next to you, and the car is gliding, and many faces I am able to see. Some are happy, some are, in trouble, different expressions of devotion. And, Swami blessing them, Swami smiling at them. And then I had a beautiful drive, and Swami took me to Gokulam, and Swami told, Radha Krishna, you be with him only. I will go inside, take Arati and come. That is a tradition from those days, because all the Gokulam people, those who are working, Swami goes personally and bless them. See, that is a beauty. Swami will never forget anyone who is, working behind also. Swami always goes, makes them happy by just giving a namaskar and giving apples to them and all that, a group photograph with them. So Swami, 10 minutes he took, he came back and again back to the car. And Swami came to the hostel. And then Swami said, get down. Then meanwhile, all the boys, Swami, please come, Swami, please come to the hostel. Then Swami said, hey, you go. Then everybody told me, hey, you ask, yeah. So I also, Swami, please. So this distance, you can, Swami, please come to hostel, Swami. Shut up. I came to drop you. I didn't come to see inside the hostel. Where is your warden? Your warden never invited me. Without invitation, do you think Sai Baba will come like that? They have to invite. Immediately, warden was standing. Swami, Swami, please come. Swami, please come. You can't invite me standing on the road like this. There is a procedure for invitation also. Ad hoc basis, how can you call me? No. I will not come like that. Swami, please come. Swami said, shut up. Get down. Swami told me. Then I thought I should not disturb Swami more. They opened the door. Boys helped me. I came outside. Swami car passed away. I sat on the chair. And then I remembered. 5 years back, Swami told. What Swami told? Ippudu digu unko turi teeskeltha. Now you get down, I will take you another day. Another day, it doesn't mean next day. In his calendar, he knows the day. And you and me as a devotee, wait for that day. That is divine day. And that is how, it is the greatest experience for me that Even casually, when Swami says something, you get down, I will take you on another day. And even if I forget, God didn't forget, you see. He remembers. And he took an opportunity and he gave me a beautiful drive. No crowd, I am alone. And beautiful, rich experience. That is why Swami says, no, Satya is my prachar. Whatever I speak, I always speak truth. That is a beautiful experience.
How do you look at it today, sir? After 2011, how did things change?
Yeah,
it is changed.
No. Swami is still with us. Swami is still doing the same thing. And it is not that Swami is not with us. This is for all brothers and sisters, those who are listening. I'm telling you, though physically we don't see Swami, but spiritually he is always with us. He is guiding us. He is supporting us. He is listening to your prayers. And if your prayers are sincere, straightforward, honest, with full of love, and if your prayers are answering, that is because Swami's blessings. One thing I always want to tell everyone is, some prayers will be answered, some prayers will not be answered. If some prayers are answered, that only gives more faith and conviction that God answered my prayer. Sometimes, so your devotion becomes more, and you own him, and you adore him much more. Sometimes your prayers doesn't answer. When your prayers doesn't answer, don't think or don't go into depression or don't feel bad that God did not answer your prayer. Please understand, if God did not answer your prayer, that means that is not good for you. What you are praying is not good for you. That you do not know, God knows. And God knows when to answer that prayer. Just like me, after 5 years, it is answered. For you also, instantaneously, it may not answer. And if it is bound to happen, and if it is good for you, it may happen at the right time, at the right moment, at the right place, at the right procedure. That is why he is divine. We are all human beings, no? We think something and we want next day that should happen. We don't have patience. But God timings are different. And we try to match God timings. That is where we, all of us as devotees, no, we falter. We don't understand God. And we immediately, God, I will not worship you. I will not talk to you. I will not do prayer. You know, immediately we cross. But God only looks at our innocent devotion. You know, poor fellow, he's upset with me just because I am not answering. But stupid fellow, he did not know that if I answer, that is not good for him. And he will know when the time comes. And then he will say, oh my God, my prayer, if only God would have answered, I would have been troubled today. Good that God did not answer my prayer. But this bulb will glow, not now, when the time comes. That is where all of us, all devotees, brothers and sisters, love him, have faith in him, leave it to him, and surrender to him. And what is good for you, he will always do.
Sai sir, there's a brother, Pramod, on watching us, and he is saying, any similar experience post-2011, if you can quote. Like, you know, people always look for some kind of a reassurance.
Okay. So, this is a long, Swami is always with us, and it is, even now it is, he's answering. If you come and pray in front of Samadhi, and if you really sincerely pray, all your prayers are answered. Provided, if it is, if God feels it is good for you, it is answered. Even now it is happening. Okay, my personal experience, I will say that, one day after my class, it's a long thing, but I will, because there is lack of time, I'll just wind up quickly.
No, we have 10 minutes.
Yeah. So what happened? One day after my classes, regular classes here, I took my scooter, and I was just in front of the hostel when I was going. There was a bit of sand, so the back wheel skidded, and I fell forward. Just like my cycle episode, no? Like that. Here also I fell forward. From top of the scooter, I fell in front. And while falling, my hand, came front. So all my body weight fell on my right hand. So I fell down. Nothing happened. I just got up. The moment I got up, I felt little awkward about my hand, feeling on my hand. That means it was hanging. This hand was hanging. I was wondering why this hand is hanging. When I'm lifting, it should come. No, why it is hanging? Then I knew this is different and this portion is different. But I always wear full hand shirt. This full hand shirt itself, like a sling, it was trying to hold my hand. And then I knew something is wrong.
Oh, and immediately, hand broke. Okay.
Yeah, it into two pieces. This is one piece and that is another piece. Only the skin is holding both. I knew something has happened. And before, you know, all the boys are also going to the hostel along with me. And I immediately told boys, come on, let's go to the hostel. And I went to the quadrangle, the main entrance, and I called for a warden. So when I called for warden, and Prushti and Satish Babu, they are coming, running. And I knew the whole hostel was rotating. When the hostel was rotating, I knew I'm going to faint. And I don't want to fall again. So immediately I told all the full crowd, all the boys have watched, no, full hostel boys are there. I said, move guys, move guys, move guys. And then I was lying down flat on the ground so that I will not fall. I don't know what happened, how long it happened. Then my shirt was wet and somebody was sprinkling water. And I opened my eyes and then they asked me what happened. I said, something wrong with my hand. Then all of them, they thought, maybe the hand is broken or something. They brought one boy's writing pad and gave support here. And then with that, they arranged the hostel Maruti van and they took me to the hospital. So there when I went, our Ravi Kumar is the X-ray department in charge. He was there. And orthopedic department, immediately they checked. They asked what is what. And I wait like this only simple thing. And then they said, okay, we will go for a scanning, and when they did the scanning and the x-ray, my elbow has come outside like this. It is outside like this. And skin is covering. This is one separately came out and it is projected outside like this. But because of the sling, it did not tear the skin and come out. That is the grace of Swami. And the skin was holding like this. It's not a bulge like this. The bone is outside like this. Then they said, we have to do a surgery. I said, okay, whatever that you want to do. Then I told Ravi and I told that surgeon, sir, whatever that you want to do, you do, sir. But only my only wish is I have to play tabla for Swami. See that I play tabla. That is my passion and that is my only prayer, sir, to you. Then he said, Babu, we will see, we will see.
Sai sir, I'm not sure if it is frozen for everybody. I think his net has frozen. Sai sir, sorry, I think his net has frozen.
Oh, are we back?
Sairam, yeah.
Are we back?
Yes, I hope. Yes, you are. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. What about you?
Okay. Yes. Now you are back. So you can.
Okay. So sorry. They did the surgery and they did close reduction. Close reduction means they pulled and tried to put it into the socket because it came out. No, it's too separate. Mm-hmm. They want to put it inside the socket. So while putting inside the socket, there is a hairline fracture on the radial head. So the doctor felt that when you're putting it slowly inside, that radial head hairline fracture will automatically heal. That was his idea. But while putting, it got chipped. It got chipped and the radial head is not there. But it went into the socket. But the moment they stretched and put it into the socket, it was loose. It was not holding. The muscles are not very tight. So they put me here 180 degrees, you know, like this. They put me with the sling. And they said, after 1 month, we have to do second surgery. I said, okay, fine. 1 month over, the second surgery. The second surgeon, Dr. Prakash, was there. He said, we'll have to cut open and then we'll have to reduce the thing. Then I said, okay, whatever it is, sir. But my only prayer is, see that I will add up to play tabla for bhajans. That is my only prayer. Then he said, see, as a doctor, I can do this surgery and see that you are able to comb your hair, you are able to eat your food, you will be able to pay, put your first button. That much only I can do. Playing tabla is an effort. And that, as a doctor, we can't do. We can help you, little bit of work by that too after physiotherapy. Long physiotherapy, you will be able to comb your hair, you will be able to brush you, because my right hand went off. No, it is not left hand, it's my right hand. So that is between you and Swami. And how fast you do your physiotherapy and how you do it, that is up to you. I said, okay, sir, fine. And then the next day was surgery. They said, the evening, 5 o'clock, you come and get admitted. I got admitted. Next day morning is my surgery. And he said, he will do first surgery for me. And it will take less time only. We will do it because the broken pieces are here. And any of the broken pieces, if it have crushed any of the nerve, my hand will go numb. My hand will be useless. So he said, I have to remove this carefully. He said, fine. And that night got admitted. And I was trying to sleep. I could not get the sleep. So nurse came, myself, my wife was sleeping in the other cot. And I was sleeping and my mind is disturbed. Swami, if only you were to be here, I will write a letter or I will send a message. And you know, you would have sent a consoling message, and you know, you will send some vibhuti packets and a word of assurance, and everything will be fine. But now I am alone. I am not there. What will happen to my hand? Swami, you are not there physically. I am literally worried, Swami. And I started crying. Nurse came. She said, sir, you must sleep. I said, madam, I need to sleep. Sir, your BP is increasing. It is 160, 170. Tomorrow morning, they have to do first surgery. BP is high, surgery. The surgeon will shout at me, sir, please, sir, sleep, sir. No, I'm trying to sleep. I'm not getting sleep. She again, after 1 hour, she came, 11 o'clock. Same condition. I'm not getting sleep. I'm awake. And then my wife was telling, you sleep? No, you sleep. I said, see, I don't know. I'm having that kind of fear. I don't know what will happen to my hand. Then my wife told, why are you worrying? Leave it to Swami. You played tabla for Swami for 40 years. You played for him. You played when he sang bhajans. You played for all the programs and he enjoyed. That is enough. Now, even if you don't play tabla, doesn't matter. But your hand should be all right. That is a priority now. Swami will take care. You sleep. Everything will be fine. And she is trying to console me. Again, nurse came. Same 160, 170. She got panicky. She gave me one more BP tablet and she gave me one sleeping tablet. He said, swallow now in front of me. I swallowed. Again, she went, nothing. And last I saw was 1 o'clock on the clock, on the my mobile phone. 1 o'clock, I saw 1:10, like that. 5 o'clock, I have to get up and get ready for the first operation. You know, there are procedures are there. 5 o'clock, I have to get up, finish all my brushing and all that. So I saw 1:10 or something like that. After that, I don't know what happened. I kept alarm, 5 o'clock alarm to wake up. Swami comes to my room and he stands next to me. And he looks at me and asks me in Telugu, I will say the sequence in Telugu. Yavaru kattaru, who tied this bandage? I said, the Swami, they only did, Swami, the nurses only did. Sariga kattaledu. They didn't tie it properly. It's not correct. Then Swami said, I will go to the next room and come. Tell them to open and tie it again. I said, yes, Swami. And then Swami went out. And people are all waiting because Swami is gone. One nurse comes with a trolley. And she ties the bandage on my hand. And then we are all waiting for Swami to come. And Swami comes again. He looks at my hand. Ippudu anni sarigga undi. Now everything is fine. Everything will be taken care. Don't worry, Swami told. I said, yes, Swami. And I saw so clearly Swami next to me. And when Swami was talking, I could see the blue tiles that room what they gave me, the isolation room was full tiles, blue color tiles. I don't know if it is real. I don't know if it is dream. Even today, I am confused. But this has happened. Immediately, I opened my eyes. And exactly 5 o'clock, the alarm is going to ring. And I woke up my wife and I told her, like this, Swami appeared. Swami stood here and Swami spoke to me like this and all that. Imagine surgery is not done. Before surgery, this is the thing the Swami was talking to me. Then my wife felt very happy. She said, see, you felt, no, if Swami would have been there, Swami will give vibhuti, Swami will do that, Swami. Now Swami himself came and spoke to you and gave you assurance. Don't worry, you'll be fine. Just leave it to him. Then I felt very happy. Okay. Now that Swami came, spoke to me, and I felt very happy. Then went to OT. They did surgery. And he said half an hour surgery, but it became more than 1 hour. The bone which was cracked, it became six parts. And they were fishing out the six pieces around the area. And my son is also a doctor. My wife is sitting outside with the same dress. The surgeon comes outside. You see how lucky this chap, that one single bone is broken into six pieces, and all the six pieces are spread everywhere. Luckily for him, not even one piece went and crushed any of the nerve. If would have damaged any one nerve, then his hand would have been a problem. But luckily, everything is scattered and never disturbed any nerve system at all. That is why it took so much time. And he said he showed the pieces, and then everything's over. I came to ICU. I was in that, you know, anesthesia was given. I was dull like that. Then night, they shifted me back to my room. And then I was there in my room. Everybody, as usual, they came and saw me, everything done. Next day morning, 8 o'clock, surgeon comes for a round. So this surgeon entered my room. As soon as he entered, my blanket was closed. He removed the blanket and he asked me, how are you, Sai sir? I said, fine. Any pain? I said, no. Yesterday's anesthesia, I think still it is there. And I'm not having any pain. I'm very comfortable only. Then he pulled out the blanket and he looked at my hand. Who tied this? He said, I don't know, sir. I don't know. From OT, I came like that only. They didn't tie properly at all. Hey, nurse! He shouted. And immediately one nurse came with a trolley. And immediately said, give me the gloves. I myself will tie. It's not done properly at all. And then he tied everything. And he said, now everything is correct. Nothing to worry. Immediately, my left hand, I held his hand. I said, the same place, sir, before the surgery, Swami stood. And the same sequence, because I never spoke to surgeon about this, only to my wife I told. I never told anybody about these things. I told, sir, same place where you are standing, Swami was standing, and he was telling me in Telugu who tied it. They didn't tie properly. Tell them to tie. And he came back and he said, now they tied it properly and nothing to worry. The same sequence you are telling me in English, sir. What is this? I am getting confused, he said. Then he said, Hare Baba, where is Swami? This is an indication to you that Swami is always with us. Is Swami. Really, I'm telling you, that is Swami. When you pray, when you miss him, and when you pray, he answers. He answers in a different way, but he assures you, damn it, I am with you. Only you people feel that I am not with you, but you are not realizing I am always with you. And this is such an experience. Before the surgery, Swami spoke to me. After the surgery, what Swami spoke to me, the same thing surgeon speaks to me. The same sequence. And same, I see the nurse coming with the trolley. Same thing happens after that. Anyway, fine, that is all done. Then physiotherapy started. And thanks to my wife. And I went to the physiotherapy room. I did not enjoy that. Because I saw small kids crying because they're stretching their legs and hand. The old man shouting. By seeing the amount of pain that they are undergoing and the shouting and the screaming, no, I can't stay in that room at all. Then I told that in charge of physiotherapy, sir, you tell me what exercise I will do in my house. I don't want to do it here. But I can't hear this noise and I'm feeling very sad. It's like hell seeing the children and the babies crying and all that. No, out of pain. I've got doctor, they have to stretch to make the leg or hand straight. They have no choice. Then thanks to my wife, every day morning half an hour and evening half an hour, she used to apply oil and then she used to stretch. And then I went and met the doctor after 1 week. He said, regularly you come and meet. So every week I used to meet him. And he said, hey, not bad. From 180, you have come down to this much. 90 degrees it has come. very good. You are doing physiotherapy very well. I said, sir, I am not doing anything, sir. My wife is pulling my hand every day. That is why it is coming. I said, whatever it is, it's a remarkable, you know, change in your this development. It's very good. Sir, when I'll play tabla, sir, if you can do like this physiotherapy sincerely, 1 year, in 1 year you will play tabla. I'm sure, I'll assure you. But you have to do this. Then that encouraged me, and I told my wife, pull more, pull more, pull more. Finally, the hand was almost coming to, not straight, but a little bit down. And then after the third week, he called me and he said, show me the grip, hand grip. I showed like this. Then he gave me a piece of paper and he gave me a pen. Can you write? I wrote Om Sai Ram. And he saw my writing. He said, fantastic. Your writing is very clean. There is no shake or no curve. That means your fingers having fantastic grip. I'm telling you, if you do like this, maybe in 10 months time, you can play tabla, he said. I said, I got even more pepped up. I said, okay, fine. And then he had a conference in, Sydney. He's supposed to go and attend a conference in Sydney for a week. So before going, what he did, he removed everything. And all the plaster, and this is the mark, the surgery mark, you can see. This is where he cut and then he removed that bone pieces and all that. Then he told me, continue. I will go to Sydney and come back. So, okay, fine. And then I fell July 11th, 2017. Year 2017, July 11th, I fell. Okay. And then August 11th or August 15th, this month only, I had my second surgery. Okay. After that, my wife is helping me doing a physiotherapy and my hand is getting stretched and all that. November 11th is Akhanda Bhajan. Okay. And all the Bhajan boys know, Sai sir, for 35 years, Swami used to give indication and you were the first person to start the Bhajan. And the last bhajan, you will only play tabla. And now, what is going to happen? Now, who will start the first bhajan? You know, now you cannot play and all that. So, everybody is feeling bad. Sai sir, only if it have been all right, you will be starting bhajan. Now, we'll be missing you and all that they are telling. So, I was also feeling bad that I am missing this. And suddenly, in my house, one old tabla was there. I thought, why not? I give it a try. So I tried to make some noise. When I lift my hand is burning. Terrible pain. Terrible pain means terrible pain. And, I thought it is not possible. It is not, we can't do this. But still, I tried little bit. Just 4 days, I was trying to do that. Just at least the action part. Then I told my tabla boys, hey, for Akhanda Bhajan, I will come and sit. Okay. As usual, we both play tabla. You sit next to me. You play loudly. And I will simply do miming part. At least I will have the satisfaction that I played tabla on November 11th for Akhanda Bhajan. He said, okay, sir, no problem. So I went and sat. And that boy was next to me. And, Ravi Kumar, all these people, Sai sir, you are taking a risk. I said, Ravi, if something happens, you know my condition. You take me to the hospital. But I must play. I want to play. Come what may. Then I looked at Swami's picture near the samadhi, behind the big picture. I said, Swami, I'm playing for you. It is your responsibility. If once again my hand is broken, you take care. And I told, bhajan started. And I started playing. Abhi, you believe or not, I played. I played for 4 bhajans. And the pain that I was going through is like, if you take a match stick and put inside your skin, how it will be burning, like that it was burning. Maybe the blood was rushing here and there, I think. That kind of burning sensation I was feeling. But I played for bhajan. And the person went to Sydney and online he was watching and he was telling his colleague, I told this fellow, it will take 1 year to play tabla. And you see, August 11th, I did the second surgery. November 11th, within 3 months, he is playing tabla there. This is what Baba is doing, miracle. This is what is Sai Baba in Puttaparthi. And that is where You see, July 11th, my first surgery. August 11th or 15th, my second surgery. August, September, October, November. November 11th is my Akhanda Bhajan 2017, and I played. And I played. You can make out the amount of pain that I was undergoing, but still, come what may, even if I die, I have to play. And I played. Successfully, I completed. This is, my dear brothers and sisters, Swami is with us. He's always with us. He can do anything. He can turn upside down.
It's so beautiful. His presence.
Yes.
Let me show you a few more pictures and we can close for night. This is your family with Bhagwan right in front of the
Yajur Mandir.
Yajur Mandir.
Yes. This is... I sold old car, Maruti van, and I bought a Tata Indica car. And I told, informed Swami that I sold the old car and bought a new car. And Swami sent word through Brother Sachadit and tell him to bring his wife and his son and the car, and I will bless the family as well as the car. And this happened just before Swami's 85th birthday. Just before.
I want to tell people that he's Sai Sai's son and he's a doctor now by Bhagwan's grace. And that is your family.
This is my family.
That is Sai's father, mother, wife and son. This is in the Bhajan Hall.
Bhajan Hall, yes. This is a close distribution.
I think in the last, you had a Sannidhi boys had started this trend. One person going to Bhagwan every day for blessing. You know,
blessing,
I think there was a nice, very nice idea so that everybody could get a chance to go to
chance.
Swami. And it was so nice. Swami was very gracious to.
Yeah. You give a rose, he'll put the rose into the pocket. He was putting that rose into my pocket.
Even the pictures look like heaven, you know.
Yes.
Such serenity, such purity, cleanliness is amazing. Very beautiful.
Yes, he is there.
Certainly, certainly always there with us. Sai sir, I have no words to, you know, express my gratitude to Bhagwan. And thank you to taking your time out to share, to take us back in this, you know, that era of Bhagwan with so much of joy and humor and emotions.
Lot of lessons.
Thank you very much. I just can't say anything more. And I'm sure people have enjoyed the last 3 weeks with you. And I hope we can have you more for another occasions and see how it goes. Thank you so much, sir. I appreciate all of you. Thank you for joining us and you know, sharing your thoughts and questions for Sai sir. And it has been a joy hearing about Bhagwan with so much of devotion and love. This video will be available on the channel. You're welcome to watch it and share it as you feel. Thank you once again. Sai Ram, sir.
Thank you. Sai Ram. Thank you, Abhi. Thank you very much. You helped me go through my, right from my birth till 2000, till latest I can say, till now. It's rewinding my life. At the same time, how much of love that Swami showered. It's not me. I'm sure every devotee who is listening, everybody has got a rich experience and one-to-one connection with Swami. I thank everyone, all the listeners, and I pray Swami from Prashanthi Nilayam to bless you and your family with good health and wealth, peace and prosperity. And let your love for Swami be more and more intense. And let that Lord bless you all to keep all of you under His loving care and His fold so that you will have a peaceful life and enjoy your life with Swami, thinking of Swami, doing some service to Swami. That is what, just listening is not enough. What little in our life that we can do for others, please do it. Swami is the best example for us. That's why Swami says, my life is my message. He lived it. He lived through all that. So what little that we can do, what little that we can help others, what way we can change our attitude, what way we can be very close to Swami, just practice. One small thing I'll wind up. Think God. Thank God. Think God all the time. And thank God every time. Because He gave us life. He gave us opportunity. This everybody did not get. Thank God for that. And think God so that He's all the time with you, above you, in you, around you, protecting you and your family. Thank you very much. Love you all. My loving greetings to all of you. Sairam and good night.
Sairam, sir. Thank you, Ved. Sairam.